Today we have with us Dr. Mangu Singh, Managing Director, Delhi Metro Rail Corporation. Thank you so much for joining us, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, tell us more about the automated drivers that you want to introduce in the Delhi Metro.
The new set of trains which we are going to deploy on new lines of phase 3 will have the highest level of automation. Meaning thereby that all operational requirement will be fulfilled by the train itself. The software will take control of the entire operation of the trains. In fact, our present trains are also having a automation level of quite high standard, maybe about 90 to 95%. And the train drivers today are required to do a very minimal work, like ensuring door closing and like that. But the other entire operation, starting of the train, acceleration, then stopping, is all automatic. But these new trains will have 100% automation, and the role of human being is completely avoided in that. So these are very efficient trains, so that way.
Do you see this affecting job creation in any way?
No, not really. When we say highest level of automation, it does not mean that there will not be anybody to attend the train, number one. And second, the technical content will be more in these trains, and also the support system. In order to maintain that support system and the technology, higher level of technology, you will need more people, but of course more at the higher level, higher end technology. And in any case, to take care of any emergency, there will be some people deployed in the trains. Okay. If not in every train, then at least some alternative trains or alternative station, there will be somebody to take care of emergencies.
Have you developed this indigenously, or have you got it technology from outside?
There is nothing like indigenous. Today the is so specialized area, and wherever the research and development and is there in the world, we automatically get, because the globally things are available. So all new metros in the world, whoever is now developing a metro system, they are going for these type of trains. It is mainly on account of ensuring 100% safety, since the human element is avoided completely, and also highest level of efficiency in the running of the trains.
Delhi Metro has always been known for bringing in innovations and new technologies. So how do you implement your energy efficiency, you know, programs?
You are right. Actually, we cannot survive without energy efficiency. You see, 40% of our operational expenditure is actually on energy, and therefore we have to be energy efficient. So right from the beginning, whether it is selection of the system or technology or processes, all are on this energy efficiency concept. Particularly our underground stations, if you see, where everything is artificial. Light, air conditioning, air also you have to circulate. And therefore huge energy consumption is there. So the technology we have selected is very energy efficient. For example, our trains are highly energy efficient, lightweight, so that the tear weight is minimum, and also having regenerative type of features, where the trains, when in braking, instead of wasting the energy, mechanical energy, it converts into the electrical energy. So to the extent of about 30%, we get back the energy. So our whole system is very energy efficient.
Do you plan to move to renewable energy as well going forward?
Oh yes, we in fact have a very, very ambitious plan for solar energy particularly. All our new stations are having solar panels, and the entire power requirement of the stations will be met by the solar only. All new stations of phase 3, and also depot. So we have a very ambitious plan of about 50 megawatt in next 3 years in Delhi. We have already achieved about 10-11 megawatt, and another 10 megawatt is in pipeline. So we have got very ambitious plan. In addition to that, we have signed an agreement with the Solar Energy Corporation of India for setting up a solar power plant, about 500 megawatt, outside Delhi, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they are already working on a power plant in the state of Madhya Pradesh.
Okay.
Where we have guaranteed them to purchase the power at agreed rate, and therefore the private player who will set up the plant will have this guarantee that there is somebody who will purchase the power from us. So I think this is a very, very good step we have taken on.
Have you already tendered the project to some?
No, we will not do the tendering part of it.
Okay.
This will be done by Solar Energy Corporation mm-hmm. of India. They will do on our behalf.
So you are only going to use the energy
Correct.
Produced from there?
Correct.
Okay. How soon can we expect the project to be set up?
I hope within 1.5 to 2 years' time,
okay.
the project will be...
You have already finalized
yeah.
the land and everything
yes, yes.
for the project. Okay, great. Coming back to your metro projects, will the Greater Noida and Noida project that is coming up, how different is it going to be from the existing lines that you have, the DMRC?
One thing is this project is owned by Noida Greater Noida Authority and not by Delhi Metro. We are constructing that line on their behalf on deposit term basis. We have also agreed to run this line for initial 5 years and then help them to develop their organization to ultimately operate the line. However, for the public point of view, for the passenger, there will not be any difference. A person entering into that line can seamlessly enter into our system, interchange at Sector 72, Noida. So for public, it will be just part of our system, Delhi Metro system.
So many shops at the metro stations are lying vacant when the DMRC thought it would get a lot of revenues from the renters. But are you losing something on that front with so many shops lying vacant?
You see, you will realize these shops we have really not constructed for the purpose of any shop or retailing. These are like byproduct. We have constructed the station and whatever is the area, balance area which is not required for our operational requirement, we have constructed these shops. And but number of stations, these are quite popular. In fact, if you see Connaught Place, Kashmiri Gate, many stations, these are quite active and these are let out. But still there are some stations where there are no taker actually. We have gone for bidding 2-3 times, but there are not many people to take. So we have come up with now a scheme where we have put these on our website and we have allowed this on first come first basis. Terms conditions are also put on our website. So whoever wants, he can come and we can let it out.
Mm-hmm. So you have taken over the airport line and this tariff, the prices have been slashed. Does it affect your revenue by any way?
Our intention or our efforts were basically for the utilization of the line, utilization of the assets. And therefore, our attempt was to increase the ridership. So, reduction in fare was the reason or the exercise we did in that direction, and it's very encouraging. Now, the ridership has in fact touched 42,500 on a particular day. So, the utilization of the system, utilization of line is there.
Mm-hmm.
Revenue wise is not much of a difference, but we are not losing. It's actually more than what it was earlier.
The odd even scheme keeps coming back and people often say that it puts a lot of pressure on the metro. So do you plan to increase the rakes going ahead with the odd even plan becoming more and more frequent?
I think one thing has to be understood. Metro is working on a planned direction. We started in 98 and entire network to cover the Delhi, to take care of the traffic need of Delhi is to be completed in 4 phases. We have only completed 2 phases. So expecting metro to suddenly take over the load of entire Delhi traffic will be, I think, not very reasonable. However, given the given situation today, last odd even also and this odd even also, we have done our best and we will try in this case also. So whatever trains are available with us and whatever best possible headway is there, we will run trains. During this period, we will hold back the maintenance part, the non-essential maintenance part. We will not take the train for the maintenance. Otherwise, normally few trains are required for the scheduled maintenance. So during this period, we take out almost all trains and don't keep them in the depot for maintenance. So we will do the maximum frequency, run maximum number of trains, and also to take care of the additional rush at the stations. Last time also we deploy additional staff, additional officers at stations, particularly those stations where likelihood of more passengers, so that booking is not a problem, ticketing is not a problem, crowd control is there. So that sort of exercise we do every time. This time also we will do.
Okay. Your third phase, the work on the third phase is going on right now. When can we expect the project to be completed?
Third phase is going on in a big way, and it's very crucial. This year is very crucial, where we have completed almost 90% of our civil works, basic works, viaduct, tunnel, stations. And now the system works are in progress. Electrification, signaling, track, those works are going on. We are still trying and hoping that all physical works will be completed by this year end. And in fact, we intend to start the trials starting from July some portion, then September some portion. But still there are holdbacks. There are two, three locations we are held up because of the non-availability of the land. So those areas are still very critical. And there are two, three models available that some states like Rajasthan for Jaipur and Kerala for Kochi, they wanted DMRC to construct for them on deposit term basis. So we have done this in Jaipur and now doing in Kochi. Places like Bangalore, Chennai, Ahmedabad, Lucknow, they wanted our services for little shorter period till such time they have their own organization. We call it prime consultancy or interim consultancy. So we have provided that support. Now they are at their own, Lucknow Metro, Bangalore, Chennai, Calcutta. So this is the way. We are in fact required so much within the country, so much work within the country, that we are not venturing outside. Though we are very much in demand outside also.
Outside India you mean?
Yes.
Oops.
And in fact, Dhaka Metro, we are part of the consultancy there. There is a consortium of consultants led by a Japanese company. We are partner in that. So we are very much in demand outside the India. It's mainly because of the cost effectiveness, and also many cities similar to Delhi are planning metro, like Jakarta, Kuala Lumpur. Their conditions are similar to ours. So our experience will be quite useful to them. So they are very keen of involvement of Delhi Metro.
Would you also look at taking equity in those projects, or is it only going to be consulting?
No, not equity we have not thought of. And in fact, we are quite happy with the level of fee we are getting with all these consultancy work.
That's great. But so much being talked about making India. Are you planning to make all your coaches in India? And I think 50-60% is already being made here.
No, in fact, 90%.
Okay.
So, DMRC right from the beginning, this was our philosophy to ensure that indigenization is there. And with our efforts, all players, all manufacturers of coach, whoever got work in India, they had to set up a manufacturing plant within the country. So today we have three plants in the country. One by Bombardier near Baroda, then Alstom near Chennai, and our own BEML for Hyundai near Bangalore. Okay. So there are three manufacturing facilities within country, and now in fact coaches manufactured in Baroda and Sri City near Chennai, they are being exported outside the country. So it is not only Make in India, it is more than that actually. So this is as far as coaches are concerned, but other fields also like track, traction, signaling, automatic fare collection system, quite a bit has been done for the indigenization, and many components are now being manufactured within the country. Right from the beginning, this requirement in our tender document, this is coming automatically. The competitiveness in the bidding, no manufacturer outside, say in Europe, can compete unless they have a more and more Indian component in that. So everybody will like to do that. So almost all, every field, the indigenization is coming. Yes, but it is it's a very temporary type of phenomena. Sometimes it still goes, comes down. That only affects the cost of a project. Sometimes it will increase, sometimes it will come down. So our all contracts have got the escalation clause, where because of the increase in the steel price, the extra payment will be made to the contractor. And if there is a fall, a recovery will be made from the contractor. So this is all adjustable. It is not, it's a very routine type of phenomena. It's not a very different thing.
Are you looking at signing any new PPAs for this? Or?
This up to 50 megawatt, we will have number of PPAs. Because we are not going in one go, because things are going down. So, as I mentioned, we have signed agreement up to about 20 megawatt. So, for another 30 megawatt, we have to sign the agreement. So, there will be number of PPAs.
Okay. So, lastly, tell us about your environment initiatives. You have earned carbon credits and you're doing great in that front. So.
Yeah, right from the beginning, Delhi Metro, before starting the work, we were very conscious about the environmental issues, and therefore all, whether it is during construction or our system, these were on the principle of environmental friendly thing. During construction, we go for compensatory tree plantation, the measures for dust control, measures for sound control, vibrations, noise, these are there in on our all work sites. They are part of the contract document and are ensured through proper monitoring. Then in the systems, we have energy efficient trains, and with all this actually, we were first in the world to get our project registered as Clean Development Mechanism project, CDM projects, and got carbon credit. So, just to give you a feel, every year we get a certificate from UNFCC that Delhi Metro has reduced about 6 lakh ton of carbon dioxide emission. So, this certification every year we get, and this is quite a good achievement.
Great, so I guess thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.